mentioned before, the open source physics project and the Tracker project have allowed several of us in the Singapore education scene to create curriculum that are completely free. And you'll notice that the things I share are all within the normal realm of digital citizenship. Okay, because in schools, you like to talk about, you use, such jargon. So I use back the same jargon with you. Let me very quickly show you what OSP can do. Open source physics. So you just type open source physics at Singapore SG, and it should appear as the fourth link, of which then you can come to this website. Okay. Now you can see that this website, I started off blogging and all that. And eventually, when I met up with some folks, like Tina in the back is taking a video of me, I realized that actually there's a lot of other free software tools. So for example, we're using Joomla. If you haven't heard of it, it's basically a content management system. So I use Joomla to house all the easy Java simulations as well as the Tracker resources. And let me very quickly just demo to you what you can do. Okay, this is still work in progress. You have to bear with me if there's some problems. Okay, so under the interactive resources, currently because you may be wondering how come I started off, now it becomes open educational resources. There's a story to it, because in MOE, I'm known as the physics man. I'm the man that uses technology for physics education. Then my bosses always tell me, oh, you need to branch out and have your impact felt. So I thought very naturally, whatever we are doing is for the benefit of all. So it makes sense that now I position this website as OER. Okay? So you can come here and you can see that now there's this whole host of resources, even chemistry one. Let me just start with chemistry first, okay? To show the chemistry folks that are here. So these are all the usual stuff that you see from PhD, but because my colleagues in EGD, we are also into sharing and scaling up useful use of technology. So I decided that we should also have some libraries for chemistry resources, of which you can see that these are all the usual PhD stuff, but let's not forget about this other resource, which is this hydrogen thing. Okay. I always like to use this as a starting point. Huh? Why talk about physics? I'm not a physics man now. I'm an open educational resource man. So this is kindly contributed by Andy. So you can see that in our website, we attribute the creators of the software. So if I have used any of Thomas' stuff, Thomas' pictures and names will appear. Okay? So you'll be very safe to know that the internet is a very well regulated space in some degree, because we are people who know how to treat and respect other people's intellectual rights. Okay, so without much ado, I'll just show you what Andy had created. So he created a chemistry simulation, which I do not want to go into the details, because even if I want to, I can't. With a single click of this mouse, you can download a simulation. With a single click of this mouse, you can have the source code for which you can further edit using Daytree's workshop materials, which is easy Java simulation. And you can even embed this simulation in your own blog. If you are into blogging, or if you have a school LMS, you can even have the embed codes here. So you can see that we have made this pretty much very useful, scalable across the globe. And with a click of this simulation, you can see that now, so Andy has created a chemistry simulation. Okay? It shows certain bouncing spheres, of which there are certain chemistry equivalents of it, and he even created this very nice visualization of certain chemistry concept, which I do not want to dwell into the specific unless Andy wants to take some time out to explain it. Okay, so you can see that we are a growing community of users, not just physics folks like most of us are. There are also other people from other disciplines that can actually harness what we do in physics to bring back to their own community. And we really want to encourage you to even share with your maths colleagues if they are ever interested in such works. Okay. So in a nutshell, we too, like at the Comprare Library, we have a search engine. So to return the favor, I would now attempt something that I have not tried before. I'm not sure whether it will work. Okay. So let's see how many resources here that we have that has the name Wolfgang in it. wow, not bad, I have one. I was worried for a while that I couldn't get any, but so you can see that this micrometer simulation. So like I said, I have not done this before, so I wouldn't know the search result as well. So I just took a chance, and you can see now this micrometer simulation in part is also contributed by Wolfgang. And when you click, again it has the usual interface. And then once you click on the simulation, okay, it comes out as this very nice little scene that you can now do a lot of... let me try to close it up. Okay. So you can see that I can actually adjust the width of it for it to be measured, and there are all these hints for which the student can now pay attention to what to look at. So I spent a good seven years in developing this together with another professor called Fukun Huang. I hope that he will come one day as well so that you can get to network with him. But all this, in a nutshell, all these materials are all here. And I wish to impress upon you that we will be here to stay for a long time, and we want you to be part of this journey.